A very good morning to all the participants, to all our viewers for today's workshop. I, Aparna from Gurushala team, welcomes you all for today's workshop. So as I move forward, I would like to talk a little about Gurushala. Gurushala is a teacher development program, which is an initiative of Indus Towers Limited and Vodafone India Foundation. It is implemented by Pratham Education Foundation. So today's topic is self-awareness and the concept of self. I think that is a very interesting topic, that having the conscious knowledge of one's own character and feelings, that is something like a superpower that everyone should have. And I'm really looking forward to today's session. So without further delay, I would like to welcome our esteemed guest and speaker for today's workshop, Dr. K. Ravikant Rao, DEO of Siddhipet, Telangana. Welcome, sir. And to talk a little about sir, is he had a very successful journey in the education sector, and he himself started off as a teacher. So he has won a massive amount of respect throughout the journey. He has received multiple awards and appreciation certificates by the district collectors. A very warm welcome to you, sir. I would also like to mention that during the session, Mr. Nagaraju sir will be acting as a moderator for today's workshop, and he will keep bringing up questions from the audience that sir would like to answer. So I would request our audience members to please keep asking us questions side by side as the session is going on. So I don't think we should delay any further. We should start. I'm sure our participants are looking forward for this session. So, sir, you can take over now.
Now, welcome to all for my session on self-concept and self-awareness. It's very happy. Second time I'm on the Gurushala platform. It's a quite interesting topic. As a part of our teacher education syllabus, and not only the teacher education syllabus, it is for every person should know about him. Self-concept, self-image, self-disclosure, self-awareness. These are the terms we often use synonymously. By etymologically, they may the same, but going into the details, psychological, they have differences. So this is, now I will start my sharing the screen. Yeah, I think now, is it visible, Aparna?
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Could you speak out? Aparna?
Yes,
sir. This is about the self-concept and self-awareness. So welcome to the session. Now this is developing people for excellence and know thyself. Here you please view some of the things here, some pictures. One is about the left side. When you see, as soon as you trust yourself, you'll know how to live. This is one of the quotations. See about the Bruce Lee. He has given one quotation. Always be yourself, express yourself, have faith in yourself. Do not go out and look for a successful personality and duplicate it. So this is another saying. Here, when you see down, there is one image, the cat is looking herself in the mirror as a lion. That how we have to look ourselves. And Albert Einstein gave one good definition or one formula about ego. That is one by knowledge. Next one, knowing yourself, knowing thyself. So these are the things which are presented about self-concept. Now this session aims and objectives. The aims are to know about self-concept, the importance of self-awareness in our life, importance of assessing ourselves in our life, knowing how to promote ourselves in various situations, and to know the components of self-concept, to understand strengths and weaknesses, to elaborate our skills in different situations. Here, it will be quite an interesting situation. This presentation will be, and this session will be going around self-concept and self-awareness topics. Once again I say that both self-concept and self-awareness seem to be same, but when we go to the definition and discussion, we'll be having different thing. Now let us go for the next one. So here I'm going to cover three topics: self-concept, what is self-concept, how it is influenced, how to develop our self-concept, and the next is self-awareness, means how to get awareness of ourselves about the SWOT analysis, very famously known SWOT analysis, and self-assessment, assessing and testing ourselves with Joe Harry Window. Now let us come for the self-concept. When we come for the self-concept, who are you? Are we to put a question? Who am I? When we put a question, who am I? You will tell about your name. Per se, who am I? Then if we put anybody put a question to me, who are you? I am Ravikant. That is the name given by my parents. But beyond that, whatever I am appearing to others, it is by name, by my physical appearance. What about my internal things? What about my thinking? What about my attitudes? What about my aptitudes? These all include the self-concept. Next, we'll also discuss about the definition and components of self-concept. Self-concept has four components: self-esteem or the self-respect, body image, personal identity, and the role performance. And within the self-concept, we also discuss influences to self-concept, positive self-concept, how to improve self-concept, and about how we'll conclude. Now here I will play a video. Please watch and make a note what is given in the video. Later you can, I will put questions, you can give your answers in the chat.
Being authentic requires that you first be aware that you are a creative and conscious being, a created self. Awareness is observing. It's being able to objectively watch what's happening inside of you as if it was happening to someone else. It is the observer that is in each of us. We are all born aware. As we grow, our sense of self-awareness develops and allows us to observe at a deeper level what we think, what we feel, what we say, and what we do. Consciousness is a part of your awareness that eventually branches off as it becomes shaped by the sources of influence in our everyday lives: parents, teachers, peers, and even society as a whole. It is how we normally experience ourselves and how we think we are perceived by the world around us. Being self-conscious, which is fueled by a fear of rejection, is when we make judgments about ourselves based on our own perceptions, as well as how we think we're being perceived by others. When we're being self-conscious, it's typically characterized by what we call our monkey mind, internal dialogue, or our negative self-talk. I'm not as smart as most people. I'm not good enough. I'm too fat. My nose is too big. I'm too this. I'm too that. I'm always. I never. Does any of this sound familiar? Have you ever told yourself something along those lines? Think about a situation that makes you nervous. Maybe it's giving a presentation. And if you hate giving presentations, have you ever listened to what you tell yourself before you gave one? Maybe something along the lines of, I'm not funny or witty. This is going to be a train wreck. What if someone asks a question I can't answer? You know, I'm going to look like a complete idiot if I screw this up. This is our self-critic talking. It repeats its message over and over, and it can often be meaner and harsher toward us than we've ever been towards anyone else. And once our self-critic has successfully convinced us that we are somehow subpar and less than worthwhile, we start to put measures into place to protect ourselves. To achieve, to gain approval, to seek applause, and to avoid rejection and painful situations. When we are consumed with protecting, defending, and managing how others perceive us, it gets in the way. We get in our own way of being aware and being who we really are. This keeps us from bringing our true self into relationships with others, and it keeps others from doing the same with us. The result is that nobody authentically shows up. Instead, we continue to run on autopilot and simply go through the motions. But really, who's in control? It's you. You are. You might think it's your self-critic, but it's you. And even though your self-critic will always be with you, you are the decider, and you get to control what you focus on. So by focusing on your awareness, on your observer, and watching yourself from a distance, you can make some observations. I'm being self-conscious right now. I'm feeling calm and happy. Or I'm experiencing anxiety and stress. And through these simple statements of observation, you are better equipped to choose to be your authentic self.
Hope you have enjoyed this video, which gave an understanding about what is self-concept, how it is influenced. So one thing, the self-concept, what we have to think is, we have to accept what we are, how we are. That we call it as unconditional acceptance. Yeah. Whether you are black, whether you are short, whether you are tall, whether you are thin, whether you are stout, whatever you are, you are. You have inherited many characteristics from your parents. So now those characteristics, physical characteristics, cannot be changed. But you can change your performance. You can improve your influence. So here, self-concept refers to the subjective description of who you think you are, or what we think what we are. So this is some of the given, I like my sense of humor, I like my body, I like being an individual like that. Here, another one is the self-concept is also known as the self-image. Means, what about you know? Is yourself in the particular situations? Here, that figure shows how it is working on. Now, let us go for the self-concept definition. It is how you know and understand yourself. I have underlined the two words, how you know and how you understand yourself. How we know? Knowing thyself, knowing our inner self. It is like our inner feelings, our thoughts about the image of ourself. It is a conceptual and mental understanding that you hold for your existence. Finally, it is given the view one has himself or herself is his abilities. So here we require to know ourselves. What are our abilities? What are our feelings? That we should be in a position to tell. One should not see his image, a lowered image. Here, in many of my sessions, I told about self-pity. You need not have the pity on yourself. You can have a good image of yourself. As the cat is viewing herself as a lion. Yes, we have innate abilities. Once you invent yourself, it's not inventing the outside world, it's not inventing the other thing. You invent yourself, then you know your potentialities. So the self-concept, how a person views himself, is a self-image, a self-worth. See this self-image here again, in both the image 1 and 3 shows her shadow, that an old lady seeing her shadow as a very young lady. So one thing is, we may be by age, physically we have become old, but mentally one should not be that much old enough. And we have to be worthy of it. I love myself. You need not hate yourself. I have that kind of, I don't have these facilities. I don't have that facilities. I am born in a poor family. It's, there are different things. Wherever you are born, wherever you are, how you are born, but you have to value yourself and don't devalue yourself before others. This you have to think in your mind and keep in your mind. That shows your real self-concept. Here, some Carl Rogers definition is given. He says that it has, again, three components: self-image, self-esteem or self-worth, and ideal self. Self-image, as I told you, how we view ourselves and how, what value you have, is called the self-esteem. And ideal self, what wish you are you really like to be. So this kind of three-dimensional idea one should have. One thing is, the good self-image improves you the your self-esteem, and that leads to your ideal self. This we have to develop in ourself, and as well as the teachers and teacher trainees, we have to improve in our students also. And don't label them, you are good, you are bad, you are waste, you are idiot. No. Give a chance to explore themselves. And see, this is the difference between self-esteem and self-image. Please make a comparison. Self-image, internal feelings. Self-esteem is also internal feelings, but it is increasing ourselves. Self-image is how you believe other people see you. Self-image is not only image of ourselves, how others see. For example, this is a very subjective one. I may appear good to some person and some other person I may appear bad. If I did a favor as a DEO to one particular person as a teacher, he feels that no, our DEO is a god, he's great. Suppose for some or other reason, if I have punished that particular person, teacher, I may appear like a bad person, like a demon. This is how you see. But one thing, it is not only your physical appearance, but our personal abilities, our attitudes, our opinions becomes a part of the self-image. Next one is self-esteem, self-worth, self-regard, self-respect, self-integrity. This number of times I have been telling. I told to my students, you respect yourself. As a person, if you cannot respect yourself, how come you can respect others? You have a respect for yourself. You have a respect for yourself, then you can respect others also. This is how we have to differentiate between the self-image and self-esteem. So self-concept has four components: self-esteem, body image, role performance, personal identity. These are all the may appears to be different terms, but they are the four different components of our self-concept. Now let us go into each one separately. Self-esteem, already explained. See here, self-esteem, when you see the figure given the right down corner, I won't do it, I can't do it, I want to do it, like that, finally you will go for, yes, I did it. See, if you have good self-esteem, you of course, when a given task is given, you may feel that you please recall your first days of your teaching profession. I'm telling to teachers. A task is given, your headmaster given, you organize science fair. Simply you say, I won't do it because it's an arduous task, it's a difficult task. Then you start with negative. When once you realize, you will go for the I will do it and I did it. This is the self-esteem or self-respect. So good self-esteem, what it gives us? Courage, power, confidence. CPC. It's not a criminal procedure code for a lawyer. It is a CPC for our self-esteem. Self-esteem, self-respect gives us courage. If you have good self-image, then you will go further. You will have courage to do anything. You believe in your powers of yourself and you will develop your self-confidence. This is how the self-esteem or self-concept will give us a boost. These are called the CPC. Now the experience of body image. See, body image is mostly subjective. You image yourself. You judge yourself. See, whether you are beautiful, not beautiful, short, tall, I told you. It how others view you, how others see you. Of course, not only the physical appearance will be the same one to all the persons. When we see some of the movie actors, though they appear to be too short, but they might have given some performances, very good performance. So this body image may become a part of the our self-concept, but here we have to think, we have to keep in mind that one should not have any poor body image which has come from the negative feelings that I am black, I am short. Whatever we are, whatever you say, we are we. Yes, maybe short, maybe small, maybe short, maybe small, but you have to be, you have to accept what you are. So here thing is, the body image is a major factor in self-esteem. Okay. But when you overcome that about your body image, you can make many miracles. See, people with physical disabilities, they have excelled many fields. We cannot say that they just only have some physical disabilities and don't have good appearance. Need not. I think you recall, once in an interview, our Big B, Amitabh Bachchan, when he approached many people for his movie opportunities, they told him, have you ever seen you in your mirror? You are tall, lean, you are rolling voice. No, you are not suitable. You are not suitable. But he has tried. Now we are accepting as the great celebrity. So this is how one should develop the good self-esteem. See, the image, the body image. Here I would like to show you some of the pictures of our Honorable Prime Minister. Now role performance. The next component of our self-concept is role performance. Given a task, how you perform in the, you better you role, better you perform given role, prescribed role. This also gives us a successful image. But one thing, if you are successful, then you can have good self-concept. Of course, you may have sometimes failures, but let us overcome the failures. This is about the role performance. Next one is personal identity. These are the different, the question of identity comes from the different aspects, starting from our personal history, uniqueness, body, brain, everything will give But not only that, you are, as a person you grow, the society will give some sort of identity. See, the identity which you have at home, excuse me. The identity you have at home may be different. The identity with your peers will be different. And the identity and the recognition with your teachers will be different. With your elders will be different. It will be different. But putting all these identities, it will show your personal identity. And you have to develop what type of person I have to be. This you have to think in your mind. So this is about the personal identity. So here, now self-concept, once you see about these four topics, confidence, self-respect, and how successfully we play our role, and our thoughts, our appearance. How our self-concept is influenced? What are the factors influencing? These are the factors when we see, starting gender, the self-concept of women or the girl will be different and boy will be different. But it is being influenced by culture. Basically, in Indian culture, boys are given more importance and girls are given lesser importance. Of course, now it is changing. The importance and the image which we attribute to the our children in their future life, they will have their own image, life experiences, relationships, age, education, everything they contribute to our self-concept. The more we are educated, the more we'll get a good self-concept. This is known. But don't think that education alone will give the good self-concept. There are many people who don't have good education, but excel in their fields. This is one. Now the positive self-concept. Finally, one should have the positive self-concept. I can do anything. I have definite strengths. This is, I am an okay person. That what we have to do. Always we should say, I am an okay person. And don't become a negative person in your field. Don't become a negative person in your field. You have to become a positive person. Always you have to become a positive person. Now, coming to the next point, how to improve our self-concept. This is one thing we have to see. Identify and recognize your strengths, learn to praise yourself, develop positive attitude, spend time with supportive friends. This all the thing is, one should have a good self-concept. One who love himself first, then only they will become the best person and they will have good self-concept. This is how to improve our self-concept. Now, let me conclude about the self-concept. Before concluding the self-concept, I request Nagaraju, any questions, any queries raised by our viewers, please go through them.
Sir, right now we are not getting any questions, sir.
Like any comments?
They are saying that session is very, very nice and we are learning so many things. So it's an excellent program and good explanation, sir.
Okay.
Only appreciation, sir.
How many are viewing now? How many are viewing this program? We have a count now?
Rightly, I am not getting that data, sir. I will check once again, sir.
Okay. So no questions now.
So around 88, sir.
Now, building a health, now self-concept, before I would like to conclude about the self-concept. This is how one should have good self-concept. That is building a healthy body image. This is, I'm telling once again, what the mere appearance will not contribute anything to your your performance levels or anything. Only thing is, you have to think and you have to perform yourself. Next one is, as you perform your role effectively, then you will get self-acceptance and you will get good identity and you will get the dignity. And body image and role performance. So now, before closing that, I am posing a questionnaire. It has 15 items. Please go through them. You take a pen and paper. You have to mark agree or disagree. Just against each item, you put A and D. I'll give just 2 minutes time. Go through each item. Please try to answer all the items. Later, I'll give you the scoring. None of the statements are neither right nor wrong. Whatever first comes into your mind, you agree or disagree. I have control over my own life. Agree, disagree, A or D. Now, please start. Please start answering the questions. These are the 15 items. I think they are visible. If you are not visible, just you can zoom your screen also. And second one is, I am easy to like. Third is, most people find me reasonably attractive. Fourth, I am glad I am who I am. Fifth, I am a reliable person. Sixth, it would be boring if I talked about myself. Seventh, I have a pleasant personality. Eighth, if a task is difficult, that just makes me all more determined. Ninth, I can usually make up my mind and stick to it. Tenth, there is a lot of truth in saying what will be. 11th, I look awful these days. Awful means beautiful. If I really try, I can overcome most of my problems. It's pretty tough to be me. I feel emotionally mature. I can like myself even when others don't. So these are the 15 items. Okay. Hope you have answered. So please count your agree, disagree and tell me how many are agree. Please tell me. Please post in the chat box. How many are disagree? How many are agree? How many are disagree? Agree. For agree, you give score 1. For disagree, you score 0. Now, what is your total score? Please post in your chatting. What is your total score? Out of 15, how many you want to agree? That will be your total score. Here, you can, any statement, either you have to agree or disagree. There cannot be any intermediate answer. I can't say. I'm seeing in the chatting. So please, what is your score? If your score, yes, Shahina Begum 13, she's telling. Archana, she's telling her score is 12. Please post. Please post your total score. These are 15 items, 15 statements. Agree, awarded 1 mark. Disagrees, awarded no marks. Suppose, and finally, I would like to, before closing this, if your total score is above 10, you have a positive self-concept. Those whoever got above 10, I congratulate them. Whose score is below 10, between 6 and 10, it is a moderate self-concept. If it is below 5, it is you have a negative self-concept. So here most of the answers I'm getting 12, 13, like that. 10, good, 12 agree. Very good, very good. Most of the people are showing. So I congratulate whoever got the score more than 10. They have very good self-concept or positive self-concept. I told you, answer whatever the first time you come into your mind, agree, disagree. There is no other category, I can't agree. Oh, great, great. Many of the people got more than 10, appreciate. And I think nobody will get 15 as such. 13 will be the maximum score. Very good, very good. Thank you. Go on posting your your total score. Very good. Now we'll discuss about the second topic, self-awareness. So we have discussed about self-concept and also what are the influences of self-concept, how to develop self-concept, and you are, might have already, all of you have assessed about yourself. So those who have got more than 10, good score. Now, self-awareness. Self-concept means is knowing our internal thing, awareness, what we are. The need to know and the fear of knowing, the Abraham Maslow says. But next one is, it is also same like self-concept, but it is knowing yourself is the key to self-knowledge and self-understanding. Self-knowledge and self-understanding. Here, self-knowledge means understanding of oneself or one's own motives. Self-understanding, awareness of ability and thing. Even at this age also, people don't know what are their motives, what they want to become. This you have to do. So self-understanding and our own actions. So now let me explain what is self-awareness. Who you really are, why you do things in the way that you do. Think about your own thinking. Care about what the people think about the field, to step back and review and self-reflection. This is FITA. Feelings, interactions, thoughts and actions together is called the self-awareness. Really, here we should know what we are, what the potentialities we have, what we can do, what we cannot do. These are the things we have to do. So here, this is a self-awareness. These are the key areas. That is our whole personality, our habits, our life, our values, not everything includes our self-awareness. Self-awareness. Next one is, how self-awareness make you more effective? If you are aware about you, whatever may be the thing, you should be aware of yourself. That will help you for skill development, knowing our strengths and weaknesses. It will improve our decision-making skills. It will help us in overcoming stress. It will motivate us and will make a good leader. See, here, self-awareness can be done SWOT analysis, which is basically any psychologist, any person will do SWOT analysis. Strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, threats. This is called as the SWOT analysis. Strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, threats. This is strengths, weaknesses, opportunities. Strengths and weaknesses are internal with the person, and opportunities are third, threats are external. So this we have to make our analysis. So this is SWOT matrix: external opportunities and threats, internal strengths and weaknesses. See how beautifully they have placed. Opportunities, the steps you are going ahead for you to reach your goal. Threats, it has shown like an arrow. It's shown like an arrow. Means they will come in your way to reach your goal. What are the strengths that shows you are? As if you are a bodybuilder, you are lifting the weights. Weaknesses, you have failed to lift the weights. So here, every person will have strengths, weaknesses, threats, and opportunities. What we have to do is improve your strengths, lessen your weaknesses, grab the opportunities, and overcome the threats in your way. Here, one more figure. See, a person with strengths, he is playing with that weight, he has lifted it, and he is rotating it. And weaknesses, he is unable to lift that weightlifting. He is puzzled what to do. Opportunities are the key of our success. One key is shown. Threats is like a bomb. Definitely they will blast our future. This is another thing. For example, strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, threats. You can say about yourself. I am hardworking. I am open-minded. I am thoughtful. I can draw any person. And the person with weaknesses, if I give any work, I'm very busy. I'm indecisive, impatient, get bored, all these things. These are the quite opposite. Next, coming to the opportunities. See, when you have opportunities, you can plan properly and you can go ahead what we are doing. Next one is the threats. Yes, threats, again, once again, I'm telling, there will be internal threats and external threats. Don't think that only external factors may cause impediment in our reaching our goal. Your weaknesses, your lack of self-confidence may also become a threat. So these are about the SWOT analysis. Again, for an employee also, we can here we see. When you are going for a job or when you are in a job, see, these are the strengths and these are the weaknesses and opportunities and threats. That is, work experience, education, technical expertise, all these things. Please go through the slide. I am not going to read. How, when you enter into a job, what should be your strengths and what are the weaknesses we have to overcome and what opportunities we get and what are threats we may face. So please go through this slide. This as an employee. Any business person, this will be the SWOT analysis example. Say strengths, yes. Next, weakness, opportunities. See, there is a ladder, even he has laid that ladder up to the sun. That shows his confidence. Next, weaknesses. See, the small thing appears to be big for us. Next is the threats. See, that arrow is upside arrow. How it is showing us? Yes. If you fall down, definitely you'll be going down and down. So what is the aim of SWOT analysis? This is SWOT analysis. Here you see the figure. It is very helpful. And it is a decision making, common purpose, organize our factors, analyze issues. Here, the SWOT analysis helps us to know what we are going to do or what we can do, what we have to do. This is the thing we have to do. Now, benefits of the SWOT analysis. Means of SWOT analysis. Here, knowing competition, decision making tool, and forecasting. This, once you enter into job or when you become an entrepreneur, this SWOT analysis not only pertains to a person, it can be for an organization also. It can be a school. It can be a person. It can be for a team. The SWOT analysis can be for any person. So please do your SWOT analysis. Here I'm giving you 1 minute time. Strength, weaknesses, opportunities, threats. I'll give 1 minute time. Please write down your strengths. Please write down your weaknesses. Please write down your opportunities and write down your threats. These are four quadrants of this SWOT analysis. I'll give you 1 minute time. Please go through them. Hope you did the SWOT analysis. Otherwise, you can do at home after this session. Strength, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. Now, the final topic of this session is self-assessment Joe Harry window. So far, we have discussed our self-concept and self-awareness. Now, we'll go for the self-assessment Joe Harry window. Why it is given in Joe Harry window? This Joe Harry window makes us to know about our feelings, experience, views, attitudes, skills, intentions, many things. Actually, this is a founder of American psychologist association, two people. That is Joseph Luft and Harry Ingram in mid 1950s. They have developed this Joe Harry window. And that is on their name, it is known as the Joe Harry, Joseph and Harry Ingram. It has four quadrants. First quadrant is open area. Second quadrant is blind area. Third is hidden area. And fourth one is unknown area. How we can know? Hidden area and unknown area. What is this open area? What is blind area? Open means which is the above two quadrants, 1 and 2, is known to all others. Everybody know. They know about our strengths and they know about our weaknesses. Hidden area, which we could not invent ourselves, and unknown area which nobody knows, neither you know nor I know. The quadrant one is open area or open arena. This is called the public or awareness. The open area is known as the awareness or the public awareness, which is mostly related to our social relations. How the persons view us is this open is known to us and known to the others also. This is called the open arena. Next one is a blind area. Unknown by the person, but others knows. We may not identify our weaknesses, but others identify feelings, incompetence, unworthiness. We may feel worthyful, but we may have our own weaknesses. This is known as a blind spot, the blind area also. So this is about yourself, but others. And the next one is, third one is hidden area, avoided area. What person knows about himself, but others do not. We hide many things. We don't want to disclose or discuss with persons. This is about the what others don't know. The hidden area. Information that you know that others do not, and others you don't want to disclose. You have your own feelings, some internal core of internal feelings. I may have angry another person, but I don't want to make him to know. Before him, I will act as if I like him. I like him and allow. I am attracted for that. Next is the fourth one is unknown area. Neither you know. And no, this is unexplored area of ourself. Still we have strengths, inherent strengths, that we have to know about ourselves. This is the thing we have to know. The unknown area, information that is unknown to you and to others also. Unknown to you and unknown to others also. And this is always present, never disappears. So this is the area we have to invent. We have to know, we have to bring it out, our unknown area. Unknown area is like our unconscious mind, our innate potentialities, that we have to bring it out. As a teacher, we have to touch this unknown area of the students. As a teacher, we have to know about this unknown area of our students. Let us bring out, give them an opportunity, definitely they will grow. So this is about, so here this Johari window, please, when you see public, blind, hidden, and potential. Means others known, public and blind. Others unknown, hidden, and the potential areas which we don't know or we know. Then how to increase our self-awareness? By doing this, our SWOT analysis, and by going through this Johari window, we have to get the self-awareness. And where this self-awareness better is, let us get the feedback from others. And we should be in a position to accept the what the criticism made by others. The feedback not only includes all praise, there may be criticism. See here, self-awareness, self-disclosure, and feedback. It's a cycle. So here, how to disclose ourselves? Here, people may disclose about themselves, but it will be totally subjective. Always we try to project ourselves good. Project ourselves good. But when the people give feedback about ourselves, definitely it will be very good one. So the communication process impact the relationships. And this self-feedback styles will help us in honesty and openness and mutual respect with each other. So here, Johari window, actually I have shown you four equal quadrants. Beginning of the relation, the open area will be less. And once you get a closer relation, you will have a open area will be more. Suppose you had a friendship with one person. So that person, you may not be knowing his inner things. But once you get interact, you get have good bondage with that person, then you will be knowing his inner areas also. This is what we have to do in our knowing our self-awareness. Now here, we have to practice our self-disclosure. We have to disclose ourselves. When we try to know about ourselves, it may be subjective, but let others give some feedback. Let others give some idea what we are, what our feelings, what our beliefs. This we have to know about others. So here, I would like to put a self-disclosure indicator. Self-disclosure indicator. Please go through them. I think it is visible. I think it is visible. If it is not visible, I'll read out. The instructions are given. Read each statement and then place a check mark in the appropriate space. Of course, now what you have to do is, you have to answer either yes or no. You have to answer either yes or no. I think you are ready now. I think now you are ready. Ready with this questionnaire. It is a self-disclosure indicator. 8 statements are given. 8 statements are given. You have to answer yes or no. Put Y or N. The first item is, In most cases, I avoid sharing personal thoughts and feelings with others. Say yes or no. There is no wrong answer, no right answer. Please make a note. In any psychological tool, there will be absolute right answer or absolute wrong answer. Only you have to answer all the given statements. Based on that, you will be given some scoring. Upon that, we can assess your personality. Second one is my relationships with others tend to be quite formal. Say yes or no. Third is, I would not be comfortable in discussing personal problems at work. Say yes or no. Fourth, I tend to avoid discussing my concerns even when feelings of frustration build inside me. Next, I tend to avoid giving praise or criticism to others. Sixth one, I tend to believe that familiarity breeds contempt. Seventh one is, I find it difficult to apologize. The eighth one is, I find it difficult to forgive wrongdoer. Hope you have answered all these one. These are all the negative questions. Please make a note. Here the scoring is for yes, 0, for no, 1. So please count how many N you got. The more yes, that means you don't want to disclose about yourself. This is the earlier questionnaire, all agree or all yes. And in this questionnaire, then they are given negative statements. Okay. So what is your final score? All no will get 1 mark or 1 score. All yes will get 0 score. Now what is your total score? Let me know what is your total score. Can anybody say what is the total score? Out of 8. If your score is more than 5, you are a self-disclosing person. Here, Sabita Dage has given, how much is Sabita Dage? What is your total score? If it is more than 5 and more, you are a self-disclosing person. You want to discuss, you are open-minded. Otherwise, you are closed, you are conservative. You are closed and so this is Ramesh says that my score is 6. Very good. We are already. Score is 6. Very good. You are a self-disclosing person. You are open-minded. You would like to discuss with all the persons. Good. So this is only Archana got 6. Shailaja got 4Y and 4N in between. So like one person who got the exact 4, they will act according to the time. So congratulations. Whatever the scores I am seeing here, 5 and above. So dear all students, you are getting very good score. Very happy. You are getting very good score. So this is about the self-disclosure indicator. Now, what we have discussed, let me summarize. We are coming to end of this session. We have discussed about self-concept, self-awareness and the SWOT analysis, and Johari window, and this is self-assessment Johari window. So this is about my discussion. So thank you. Nagaraju, any questions or any queries, please post.
Sir,
Sir,
There are two questions, sir. Sir.
Yes, sir. I think sir is the network must be of an issue, but that's completely all right. I think sir gave a very amazing presentation. If the way that he made it, the way that he created it, and there were so many activities. I hope all our audience members did the activity. They did. I definitely did. I scored myself. And there's always a surprise. The thing about these activities is that there's always a surprise with the score. You might expect, okay, I might be getting this much, but then you end up getting this much. I think it was great that our audience was interacting with us. A lot of them wrote their scores. For example, Jackie Reddy, ma'am or sir, also gave this course. Yes, so sir is back, and continue, sir, the question answering session.
Sir, it's a very good session, sir. One of our viewers is asking that how to interpret self-confidence in students.
Yeah, please repeat.
How to improve the self-confidence in our students.
Okay. So here, self-confidence, I told, don't label your child. You are good or you are bad. Don't say that you are waste, you are idiot. Don't say. Sometimes they may perform good, sometimes they may not perform. Based on the situation, try to encourage the students. Never discourage the students. See, don't see the students from your point of view. Your point of view, you may have very good abilities, but what is the age group of that student? If he is able to answer for part, okay, good. You have answered very well. Try to improve. That we have to do. Always you have to go in a positive way. That only can improve the self-concept among the students. Next. Nagarath, unmute yourself. Unmute.
So we did so many activities to self-assess and self-improvement. Can we do these activities with our students also?
Then this is for an open questionnaire. This is for every age group we can do. And you modify those statements accordingly. See, those statements are given. You try to convert them into actions for your students. Then you can improve the good self-concept among your students. Not only among the students first, let it be developed among you all first. Then let us go for the other. Okay, next. Any question?
Sir, one more question is there. What is the major difference between self-esteem and self-respect?
See, these are both are same, okay? Synonymous words. Actually, psychologically speaking, we call it as self-esteem. But in the normal course of time, you use as a self-respect.
Respect.
I think people who have studied about psychology, Abraham Maslow, when you go for that, self-esteem is the third point.
Yes, sir.
Maslow's pyramid of needs. Next.
Sir, these are the questions posted by the viewer, sir. I think the presentation is very nice, so that we are not having so many questions here, sir. Almost all the doubts has been cleared in this presentation itself, sir.
And, first, thank you, Nagaraj, for moderating, and thank you the Gurushala team, Tanvi, Aparna, others. Once again, I got an opportunity to become a psychology faculty. Though I am working as DO, but I am a psychology faculty. I did my doctoral in psychology. I feel very happy while taking the session on self-concept and self-awareness. And as Tanvi told, sir, let us make this situation, this session as more interactive and lively. That's the reason two questionnaires and one video is presented. So that it will be very useful for the viewers. Because psychology subject itself is people felt like mathematics was a tough subject. Like mathematics in teacher education, psychology is felt as a tough subject. So I want to make it more easy and more interesting. I hope I have reached the expectations of the viewers and the Guruchala. Thank you. Tell me, you can conclude.
Aparna.
Much, sir. I think this whole conversation is very important to have for everyone. Just like I said, like I mentioned in the beginning, that knowing oneself and understanding one's own feelings and I think character is, it's like a superpower that everyone should have, you know. It automatically changes a person's human nature once they know themselves first. And you know, the whole, they become more kind, they become more, I think, gentle. That is what I feel. I think that is what my thinking is. But you gave a lot of activities how we can understand our own self, SWOT analysis. It's also very important, I think, in career-wise, it's important to know your strengths, weakness, opportunities and threats so that you're more prepared to work in the, you know, whatever the organization you're applying for. So I think, thank you so much. I definitely, like I was mentioning, I did all the
activities. Just a minute, Aparna, just a minute. What were your scores? For a first questionnaire?
So first was it was more than 10, which okay, I don't think, oh, which was a good thing. And the second was it was 7. So
7? Oh,
yes.
So you are open person, self-disclosing person.
Yeah, I think I need to work, or everybody needs to work on themselves, I think. But I think it was fun. I enjoyed doing all the activities. And the good part was that in the beginning, I didn't know why, what would happen if I say yes, what would happen if I say no. So I think that's a good thing that you disclosed it after how what does yes mean and what does no mean. So yeah, that I think we all enjoyed this session. So thank you so much for such a fruitful session.
Thank you.
All right. And yeah, it was delight to have. Thank you, Nagaraju sir, for moderating.
Thank you.
And both of you, thank you for joining us for today's session.
Thank you. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you, sir.
All right. So before we end today's session, I would like to tell our audience that Guruchala is a platform where there are so many opportunities for teachers or even aspiring teachers to be a part of Guruchala and interact with so many other teachers who are connected with us all over India. And so I would just like to give a very small glimpse of our website. And on our website, there are certain spaces like teacher communities and staff room. So as I'm sharing my screen, and we can see it, that I'm on the Guruchala's homepage, and I can see a lot of things that are being shown on my screen. So on the left hand side, I can see there are four things. On the center, I can see there are four things. So courses, we have free self-paced courses on our website that teachers or aspiring teachers can enroll in them for free, and they will also get a certificate. Apart from this, there's a content library which has a lot of resources that we can use in our classrooms. Then staff room is a space where we connect with teachers all over India. We can post our questions, something that we have to say to other teachers. Similarly, Research Corner is a space where we can read teacher stories. So we have a lot of submissions on teacher stories. We try to cover as many as we can of the teachers who are connected with us. So here you can find them. And on the left-hand side, we can see there is an option of teacher communities. So as I go to teacher communities and I click on it, I will see a lot of names coming up, a lot of different themes coming up. And so this is a space, I would like to tell you all, this is a space that which has small communities, small groups where teachers come together and they try to have a conversation on that particular theme. So the reason I opened this today is because as we were talking about managing self and self-awareness, so I think we all must have tried knowing and understanding ourselves. And we just want to know your strategies, your ideas, and basically what you think about managing self and self-awareness means to you. So here we have a community called Managing Time and Self. I hope we can see it on our screen. So here's an option to join. Now, when I click on join, it will automatically tell me to log in, because without logging in, I cannot open all the communities. I cannot write anything on the communities. So make sure that whenever you join a community, whenever you want to write something on the community, you should log in. So as the box has come to log in, I have a lot of options. I can log in through phone number. I can log in through Facebook, and I can also log in through my Gmail ID. If I haven't registered already, then there's an option of signing up. That means when I click on this, I will be registering to be a member of Gurushala, which is, of course, for free of cost. So I'm comfortable with the Gmail ID. So I'm going to open through my Gmail ID. Now, as I can see, when I'm in the process of logging in, after successfully logging in, I'll be back on the teacher community page. So that was just a small process of logging in. I'm back on the same page, and now I can join. So there's a button to joining this community. When I click on it, it's simply going to tell me that I've successfully joined in the community, and I'll be back on the same page. Now that I've joined it, here it's going to say joined. So I will simply click on managing time and self, and I can see that there are a lot of postings that the teachers have already done. There's a Baljeet Kaur ma'am who has already posted some time management principles. Similarly, other teachers, Rinku ma'am and Manju ma'am. So many teachers are sharing already. This is how I would request you all to be a part of Gurushala and register today and log in and share with us your ideas. So this was a small glimpse of what Gurushala looks like. There is a link in the description box. If you want to go to teacher communities, there's a link under this video, Facebook video, in the description box. When you click on it, you will reach the community section, and it'll be easier for you to join them. So thank you for being a part of the workshop, and we hope you do log in today on Gurushala. We will keep having such workshops. Gurushala also organizes webinars and exciting competition for our teachers. If you have any ideas of what next topics or themes that you would like to hold a workshop or webinar, you can definitely write to us on our staff room page, on our teacher communities. And in case you have any more questions, you can do the same. Stay connected with Gurushala by liking our Facebook page and subscribing to our YouTube channel. We hope you have a great day ahead. Happy teaching.